Hello, my dear children. Hope all of you are fine. Today we are going to discuss about the extraction of metals from soil. In this, you will learn the occurrence of metals and extraction of metals from the soil. We know the earth crust is the major source of metals. The elements or compounds which occur naturally in the earth crust are known as minerals. At some places, minerals contain a very high percentage of a particular metal and that can be extracted profitably. And there the minerals are known as ores. Extracted profitably in the sense, we extract these metals from the soil for a commercial purpose. Example, gold ore. We extract for commercial purpose. Now you can see a table which indicates the reactivity of some metals. Here the reactivity decreases from top to bottom. First we can divide the table into three different groups. One is metals of high reactivity. Potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium all comes under this group. Second one is metals of medium reactivity. Zinc, lead, iron, it comes in the group medium reactivity. Mercury, silver and gold comes in the group metals of least reactivity. So if you have this knowledge, the entire session will be easy for you. Okay, so here the highly reactive metal is potassium and least reactive metal is gold. Some metals are found in the nature's free state and some are found in the compound state. Compound state means either as their metal oxide form or metal sulfide form or carbonate form. The metals at the bottom of the reactivity series are least reactive and they are often found in free state. Example, gold, silver, etc. Even copper and silver are also found in the compound state as their sulfide or oxide ore. Example, copper oxide, copper sulfide. The metals at the top of the reactivity series are so reactive and they never found in free state. They are always found in the compound form. For example, potassium oxide, sodium oxide. And the middle of the reactivity series, the metals are moderately reactive and they are found mainly as oxides, sulfides and carbonates. Example, zinc oxide, zinc sulfide, zinc carbonate. And on the basis of reactivity, we can group the metals into three categories. Metals of low reactivity, metals of medium reactivity, metals of high reactivity. See children, when we extract these metals from soil, based on their reactivity only, we can extract them and purify them. Our main intention is to purify the metal. So how can we purify the metal? That is what we are learning in this part. So, based on the reactivity only, we can collect it and we can purify them. Now, we're showing the steps involved in the extraction of pure metal from ores. Ores, when we extract from the earth, usually contaminated with large amounts of impurities such as soil, sand, dust particle, etc. We generally call them as gangues. So, the impurities or the gangues must be removed from the ore prior to the extraction of the metal. So, that we use different methods for removing the gangue from it. Here, we cannot apply the same method for all the metals since they are having different reactivity issues. So, here we apply different methods. So this is just a flowchart indicating the separation or the extraction of metal. How are we getting pure metal? Some are in the form of metal sulfide, so we have to extract it. So here, extracting metals low in the activity series. Metals in the low activity series are unreactive. So here, if it is a metal sulfide, we have to convert it as metal oxide. Again, when we heat it, it converts as pure metal. Three steps are there. So first, here you can see one example. Cinnabar is an ore of mercury. When it is heated in air, it first converted to mercuric oxide. Again, when we heat it, mercuric oxide is pure mercury. So this is just three steps. First, metal sulfide. If it is a metal sulfide, it should be converted to metal oxide by heating. Again, when we heat it, it converts to pure metal. So here, metals in the low in the activity series are extracted by that method. Here, extracting metals in the middle of the activity series. These metals are moderately reactive and usually they are present in the sulfide or carbonate forms as metal sulfides or metal carbonates, zinc sulfide, zinc carbonate, etc. That must be converted into metal oxide first. So we apply two different methods for that, calcination and roasting. The carbonate salts are converted into oxides by heating strongly in limited air. That process known as calcination. The sulfinoses are converted into oxide by heating strongly in presence of excess air. This process is known as roasting. Here, two different methods applied for separating sulfide or carbonate ores. Here, examples are given. Roasting, you can see zinc sulfide. Zinc sulfide, when we heat it, it converted to zinc oxide. And again, that zinc oxide, when it is heated, it's a metal oxide. When it is heated, it converts to pure metal. And calcination, you can see zinc carbonate, when it is heated, it converted to zinc oxide. Again, when it is heated, it converted to pure metal. And not only that, we use reducing agents such as carbon. Carbon reduces that metal oxide to pure metal. Even displacement reactions are also used to convert these sulfides or carbonates to metal oxides. Again, when we heat, it changes to pure metal. We already learned displacement reaction, that highly reactive metal displaces the least reactive metal from its compound or in the solution form. Here, thermit reaction. See, displacement reaction, as we know, that is highly exothermic. The amount of heat evolved is so large, so the metal produced in the molten state. Here, you can see one example. Iron oxide react with aluminium. This method commonly we use for joining railway tracks. Here, aluminium is more reactive than iron and it displaces iron from ferric oxide and forms iron and aluminium oxide by releasing large amount of heat. See children, this thermit reaction is little bit important. Please mark this one. Usually they ask what is the method used to join railway tracks, and the equation also important. Please mark it. So metals at the middle of the reactivity series can be extracted by these methods. I hope you understand. I will explain the extraction of metals at the top of the reactivity in my next video. Since this is a big topic, we will stop it here. All of you have to learn this part. Okay, and today just what we learned. See, extraction of metals. The main thing what you have to know is, based on the reactivity of metals, we use different techniques to separate them. If it's a metal sulfide or metal carbonate, we use and whatever it is, first that should be converted to metal oxide. Again, when we heat, it convert to pure metal. Three steps: metal sulfide or metal carbonate, when we heat it, it convert to metal oxide. Again, when we heat it, it convert to pure metal. This is the only thing you have to remember. I hope you understand. Thank you.